I think that one of the most useful tools you can have for your computer setup is an Elgato Stream Deck, which is good for a lot more than streams yet. Mine just sat in the closet for literally years because I didn't understand until relatively recently just how useful it could be. It really wasn't until my wife Heather started using a Stream Deck in her setup that I saw how valuable and customizable it could be. And then my friend Luis, probably better known as Mr. Camera Junkie, is the one who also helped me to see that it could really be expanded to your entire operating system setup, and it can be a really dynamic tool to use. So while there's basically an unlimited number of things you can do with the Stream Deck, what it's really been helping me with lately is Final Cut Pro. It has totally sped up and streamlined my editing process, and that's what I want to share with you today, is how the Stream Deck can make Final Cut Pro better. Yo, bro. So what I've done is create a profile for the Stream Deck. If you don't know how to do that, you can just open the Stream Deck software, which is totally free from Elgato's website, and you should install it when you install the Stream Deck. And this is where you will see all of your different profiles. So if you're doing different streams, different shows, different uses, you can create a different profile for everything. So I have made a Final Cut profile. Now what that means is when I open up this profile here, I can then add specific actions for Final Cut. I did click this little plus icon up here, which will take you to the Stream Deck store. And if you search for icons, you can look up Final Cut Pro. And there's a totally free icon pack, which is really helpful. And then basically, if I create an action and I drag something to one of the keys, instead of having the default just nothing icon, I can open the Stream Deck icon library. And all of the Final Cut Pro ones are right here. Now, one of the things that held me back from using the Stream Deck for a long time was I felt like I didn't know how to use it to its full potential. And I was like scared to learn how to do that. And I thought that if I didn't have it all maxed out and optimized, that I would be like, I don't know, a Stream Deck poser or something and couldn't use it. And I was completely wrong. So a lot of times it comes in its little stand, you know, which is great for when you're streaming. But when I'm using it with Final Cut, actually don't use it with the stand, and I did buy an extension USB cable so this can reach pretty much anywhere, and I like to just have it right next to my keyboard. And so what I did was, instead of trying to base my workflow on what somebody else did, I left it blank and started editing a project in Final Cut Pro. And when it comes to using any software application, there are certain things that are just annoying sometimes. For me, one of the most annoying things in Final Cut is doing the multi-blade, like cutting through multiple layers of footage. So for example, a lot of times if I'm not using the multicam feature, I'll end up with a project that looks like this, where I've got audio, different tracks of audio, different tracks of video, and I'm trying to cut between them. And to do that, you can press Shift Command B and it will slice shing all between every layer wherever the playhead is. And it's not hard to do Shift Command B, but if you're going through 20, 30, 40 minutes of footage and you're doing this constantly, it's like your fingers are just crab walking all over the keyboard. It's just kind of annoying. So what I did is right in the middle, I used one of those icons and I called it cut. And basically it's just a hotkey for shift. Uh-oh, I deleted it. Well, great. This is how you would do that. Let's delete it and start from scratch. When you're dealing with your Stream Deck, you can oftentimes find specific actions for specific software. So like Zoom has specific actions. Ecamm has a bunch of specific actions. But in this case for Final Cut, I'm mainly just using the default system actions, and pretty much everything is built around hotkeys. So I'm gonna drag a hotkey to the middle, which is really cool, as you'll see. And I'm going to then change the icon to the cut icon from my library. And then hotkeys, you just click right there and then type in what you want. So I'm gonna do Shift Command B. And now it's Shift Command B. I don't need a title because the icon already says cut on it. And now when I'm in Final Cut Pro and I press this button, it does that command, Shift Command B. I can just play through this and keep my hand here, and every time I need to do something, just cut it, and it's just so much quicker and easier. Another thing that I've added in this profile is balancing color. So changing the color on a clip is pretty easy in Final Cut. You can click on a clip and then go up and do the little color wheel triangle up here. But a lot of times if you're going through lots of different clips, you find yourself bouncing back and forth between the inspector and the color wheels. And now I can just do a clip, press this color option, and it's gonna open up color wheels. I've also added zoom in and zoom out, which is something that you use a lot when you're in Final Cut Pro. So as I'm going through here, instead of doing Command plus, Command minus, now I can just press these plus and minus buttons. And I put them right next to each other, which makes sense. This little icon down in the corner is actually to switch profiles. So that will let me go to all my different Stream Deck profiles. Up here, I've actually done audio. And so this is an audio devices plugin that I installed, which let me set an audio device. And so you drag it to one of the keys, and then you can decide if you want it to be an input or an output. Like, are you switching microphones or do you want to switch speakers? So I have one that's going to be my computer's built-in speakers, one that's going to be my headphones, and one that is the Rodecaster Pro if I'm just running the audio out through the Rodecaster Pro, which I do a lot. How you position the keys, of course, can affect your workflow. I put the cut in the middle because that's my most commonly used one that saves me the most frustration. And the home key, the middle key on the Stream Deck, does have a bump on it. So you can tell just by feel which one that is. And then from there, you will know wherever you put everything else, you know, just whatever works for you. You'll also notice that I have a bunch of blank keys. And the reason for that is exactly what I was telling you earlier. You don't need to like have this totally optimized to be an official Stream Deck user. Just do, you know, just work with what you got. And then all you need to do is sort of be super aware while you're editing in Final Cut, any of those things that cause friction or annoyance, make a note of that and then add it as a hotkey or an action on the Stream Deck. So your configuration will be, you know, very different than my configuration. For example, something that just popped into my brain as I'm recording this video is, I think it's Command 7. Yeah, to bring up the vector scope and all the color things. That's kind of an annoying one for me. So I'm gonna make a hotkey for that right now. And I'll just add a hotkey here and then click to assign and it'll just be Command 7. And so now when I'm here, I can just do boop. There we go. And when I don't need it, it'll go away. Now it's super easy. Because this very useful tool is now easier to access, that means I'm probably gonna use it more because I can be a very lazy person and I don't wanna do things that are inconvenient sometimes. So if I make it more convenient, I'm more likely to do it. And of course, if you decide that you wanna rearrange or reconfigure things, you can easily just drag your keys to different places and do whatever works for you. But I really can't tell you how much just having my little Stream Deck right next to my keyboard, this has totally been an absolute game changer for my workflow, and I think it could do the same for you. Now, of course, I am only speaking about Final Cut Pro here, but if you want to learn more about the Stream Deck and how it can basically affect your entire workflow and you're looking for that broader overview, my friend Luis, Mr. Camera Junkie, has an entire video on his channel where he dives into that more in depth. And like I said, he's the one that helped me really figure out how to bring this into my workflow in a big dynamic way. So check out his video, make sure to say lots of nice things to him along the way. And then you can say, what the heck? The Stream Deck is cool.